Welcome all. Just as we have seen key point in the Z parameter, now it's time to see key point in the Y parameter. So whenever we have a pi type of network, then without using KVL, KCL, you can easily get the value of Y parameter. And important thing is that Y parameter has a unit of mho. Okay. So this y11 is nothing but addition of these two, ya plus yc. So y11 is ya plus yc. Then y12 is minus of yc. y21 is minus of yc, minus of this resistance. And y22 is addition of these two. That means yc plus yb. So this is my y22. Very simple. y11 addition of these two, ya plus yc, y12 minus yc, y21 minus yc, and y22 is yc plus yb. So remember this matrix. It is very helpful to solve questions. Okay. So example, so this one pi network is provided and we have to determine the y parameter. Okay, so as the here the quantities are in ohm, my first task is I should convert this into mho. So 1/2, so y is 1/2 is 0.5 mho, yb is 1/4, that means 0.25 mho, and yc is, this is yc, 1/5, that means 0.2 mho. Once I have converted quantities into mho, I can easily get the y parameter. So y11 is ya plus yc. So y is 0.5, yc is 0.2, so 0.7, 0.5 plus 0.2, 0.7. Then y12 is minus yc. So minus 0.2, because yc is 0.2, minus of 0.2. y21 is minus yc, so minus of 0.2, yc is 0.2, so minus of 0.2. And y22 is yb plus yc, so 0.25 plus 0.2, 0.45. Very simple. Okay, now let's look at the GATE 2010 examination question. For the two port network shown below, the short circuit admittance parameter, that means short circuit admittance parameter, see here, they have, instead of asking y parameter, they have used the word short circuit admittance parameter. So this is one trick. The question is not straightforward. So we have to determine the y parameter. Okay. Now the quantities are in ohm. So this is another trick. So first of all, convert this ohm into mho. So 1 upon 0.5, 1 upon 0.5, 1 upon 0.5. So 1 upon 0.5 is 2. So ya is, this is ya, is 0.2 mho. Ya is 2 mho. Yc is, this is yc. So this is also 2 mho, this is yc, and this one is yb, and yb is also 1 upon 0.5 is 2 mho. Okay, so this is the first task. Now second task, what is the y parameter matrix? y11 equal to ya plus yc, so 2 mho plus 2 mho, 4 mho. Then y12 is minus of yc, so minus 2. And y21 is minus of yc, so yc is 2, so minus 2. And y22 is yb plus yc, so 2 plus 2, 4. And another unit for mho is Siemens, as the options were in capital S means Siemens. Okay, so correct answer is 4 minus 2 minus 2, 4. That means my option A is correct. Now let's look at one more example. So this one is a GATE 2015 question, same concept question. The two port admittance matrix. Admittance matrix means y parameter matrix for the circuit shown in figure. So one pi network is provided. What is the first task? Convert quantities in ohm into mho. So 1/10 mho, 1/5 mho, and 1/10 mho. Okay, so this is y a, this is y c, and this one is y b. So this is the first task. Now second task, what is the y parameter for pi network? Y 11 equal to y a plus y c. So 1/10 plus 1/5, and 1/10 is 0.1, and 1/5 is 0.2. So 0.1 plus 0.2, 0.3. Then y12 is minus yc. For pi network, y12 is minus yc. So minus of yc. Minus of yc means minus 0.2. y21 is same minus of yc, and it is also minus 0.2. And y22 is yb plus yc. Yb is 0.1, yc is 0.2. So 0.1 plus 0.2, 0.3. So out of four options, my option A is correct answer. Okay. Now, one more key point for you. Suppose I have an X matrix and elements are A, B, C, D. So, what will be determinant? AD minus BC. This is the determinant. And if I want to find the inverse of this matrix, that means X inverse. So what I have to do, I have to divide by the determinant. So 1 by determinant into matrix. So here A is there, here D is there. So interchange these two. So this becomes D here and A here. Now don't interchange these B and C. Instead, just put minus sign. So minus B and minus. So we get the inverse of a 2 by 2 matrix. Once again, I will repeat, find out the determinant AD minus BC. So 1 by determinant into matrix, interchange this diagonal element and put here in this opposite diagonal element, put minus sign. That's it. So we get the inverse of a matrix. Now relationship between Y parameter and Z parameter is, we know that impedance equal to 1 by admittance, but as it is a matrix, so 1 by y means y inverse. So z parameter matrix is inverse of y parameter matrix. Similarly, our y parameter matrix is inverse of z parameter matrix. Okay, so now let's look at the GATE 2014 question. For the two port network shown in the figure, the impedance matrix. So here they have asked Z matrix in ohm is. So first of all, we will find out Y matrix and we will find out the inverse of that. We can get the value of Z matrix. Okay. With pi network, it is always easy to determine the Y matrix. So pi network type of network is provided. It is very easy to get the Y matrix. And just take the inverse, 2 by 2 inverse is also easy. We can get the Z matrix. Okay. So as the quantities are in ohm, so convert this into mho for Y parameters. Unit of Y parameter is mho. So convert the ohm into mho. So take the reciprocal. So 1 by 10, 1 by 30, and 1 by 60. So 1 by 10 is 0.1. 1 by 60 is 0.0616. And 1 by 30 is 0.033. Okay, so what is y a plus yc? So 0.1 plus 0.33. So 0.1 plus 0.33 is, okay, 1 by 10 plus 1 by 30 is 4 by 30. You adjust 3 here, so it becomes 30, in the denominator is common 30, so 3 plus 1, 4 by 30. And my y12 is minus yc, yc is 1 by 30, so minus 1 by 30. Here also minus yc, so minus 1 by 30. And y22 is yb plus yc, yb is 1 by 60, and here it is 1 by 30. So adjust here 2, multiply by 2, and divide by 2. So 2 by 60, denominator is common, and 2 plus 1 is 3 by 60. So we get the Y matrix. The next step is find out the determinant. So 4 by 30 into 3 by 30, 60 minus -1/13 to -1/30, so minus minus cancel, but here is 1 minus will be present. Okay, so if you solve this, the answer comes out as 5/900. So this is the value of determinant. So 1 upon determinant is 900/5, that means 180. Now interchange these two. To get the inverse, interchange these two. So 3/60 and here 4/60. So I have interchange. And here simply put the minus sign. So here I already -1/30 is there. So it will be +1/30. Here -1/30 is there. We just have to add the minus sign. Minus minus becomes plus. So here also +1/30. And 1/(Δy) is 180. So after that, you can multiply this 180. Okay. So each term gets multiplied by 180. So 180 is 3 and 60 is 1. You get some, it will get cancel out like this. This is 1. So 3 into 3, 9. This is 6. This is also 6. And this is 6 and this is 1. So 4 into 6 is 24. So this is my final answer for the Z matrix.